Oh, hey, didn't see you there. Welcome to Cluster What? Oakland University's... Oakland University's best, greatest, and only comedy sketch show. I'm your host, Jay Kustosh. Let's have some fucking fun, dude.
Cluster.
He beat the fuck out of him!
He beat the shit out of him too!
Oh, what? Oh my god! Are you kidding me? He beat the fuck out of him!
It's me. Hey, it's me, Jake. You know, from hosting Cluster What? I'm hiding out in the dark right now. I don't know why. But, let's go to the next sketch. Yeah. Alright.
Hello, I'm Aurora Windsong. Most people call me Steve, and I've been a vegan for 10 years.
So, when did you ultimately decide to become a vegan?
Well, I've been vegan since I was about like 10, 11. My mom's a strict pescatarian. My dad is a devout vegan, which is always kind of weird, I thought, because he comes from a family of butchers.
So how do you feel right now?
I'm a little nervous, I'm not going to lie, but I'm pretty excited.
So the first thing we're going to have you try today is the McDonald's McDouble.
All right. Been missing. Hold on. Yeah, it's pretty good. I like it.
So the next thing we're gonna have you try is a burrito from Chipotle.
All right. I've heard a lot of good things about Chipotle. Yo. Oh my god. Yo. Oh my god. Wow. Wow. That is, oh my god. Wow, Jesus. Woo. That. Yeah, I'd probably give that one 8 out of 10.
So you think you're going to go back to being a vegan after this?
Yeah, I think I'll go back to being a vegan. Yeah. It was a good experience, though.
All right, and cut. That's a wrap, everybody.
All right, thank you.
Want to get some pizza later?
Yeah.
Awesome. You know you have to pay for that. You know, you gotta pay.
Listen, Jake, I know it's been a long day, and I know it's real frustrating,
okay?
How
many times do we have to do this, though?
Hey, it just one more, hopefully. One more, hopefully. He's not, you know, it's just, he's not that coordinated. It's just not everyone can do that. You good?
All right, fine.
All right.
Yeah. One more, I swear. One more. That's it, though.
Thank you. That's all I'm asking.
God damn it! Fuck you, Frank, you talentless hack.
What a work of art.
This is your Batman. What do you think? Oh crap, I should have seen. Dealing with things in a different way, like Christian way or a smarter way. There will be no judgments made. Not one judgment. There'll be a free space to speak your mind. If you know nothing at all about God or who he is. Oh, did you just assume his gender? Did you just assume God's gender?
Hey, bro. You smoke weed? My question is, if you had to cut off a limb in order to survive, what limb would it be, and how would you cope with the mental anguish in the years to come?
What?
You're going bobsledding?
What is that?
On a sled that bobs on the snow?
No.
Oh, you should try it. It's so sick. All right, I'm here with...
Axel.
Axel, what's your favorite pickup line?
Do you have a map? Because I just got lost in your eyes.
Sorry, dude, I'm not gay.
Probably think I'm scheming. Think I'm just like every guy and that I'm always fiending. You go look me up and down and ask what's the meaning. You've been cold with the extras like a movie screening. Trying to get my buzz up, drop the EP then what? Go award touring with the tribe. Cause you know I quest love, cause I'm sticking to my...
He just hit us with like 50 bars. Hey bro, you smoke weed?
Huh?
You smoke weed?
No.
Alright. What's the hardest you ever YOLO'd?
Hardest I ever YOLO'd.
Yes.
Like you mean the you only live once thing?
Yes, but as a verb. Do you guys play piano?
Love a duel.
You play something?
Just
I'll follow up. I'll play after. Can I get down here real quick? Time for me to play the piano that I've been practicing my whole life.
I've been practicing my whole life for this event.
I call this piece Love is in the Sky.
Love so deep it hurts.
That's beautiful.
That's Love in the Wind.
Love in the Wind.
Follow me on SoundCloud.
Actually, no joke, that hurt.
It's like cut your
it's
finger
like
right on the
flat keys. And just like,
I thought it looked so smooth in the movies, dude.
One thing about ClusterWhat is there'll be two versions. One for
ClusterWhat channel.
One that'll be on
Student Video Productions channel.
Which will be censored. So those watching on
Student Video Productions channel,
they won't be able to read this message because it'll be blurred out. All right. Play the next sketch, dude.
Alright everyone, today we will be unboxing the NES Classic Edition. Also picked up the Edge joystick, which we will also be unboxing, and also this sick controller extension cable. You know, I'm pretty excited for this one. Let's just get right into it. Let's take this thing out the box.
As you can see, everything has been taken out the box.
Everything that they said would be in the box was in the box. So...
Alright everyone, thanks for watching my unboxing video. Make sure you leave a like, hit that subscribe button, and leave a comment about which type of box you want to see me unbox next. Thanks. Today, I'm going to be playing Ghosts and Goblins. Supposedly this is the most difficult game on the NES. I haven't played it yet, but I'm looking forward to it. So let's get it started, it should be fun. Oh shit! They stripped my clothes when they killed me? Can I get my suit? I want my suit back. I'm insecure about my body and I want my suit back. Alright, second try. Diglett over here. Oh shit! Flying Diglett! Flying Diglett killed me. Shit! Fuck you, Diglett. Fuck you, Diglett. Fuck you, Diglett. Fuck you, Diglett. Can your boy get some checkpoints? I just wanna wire me and my wife chilling in a graveyard. Like it's no big deal. Just casual picnic at the graveyard. Hey, babe, you wanna go say what up to your uncle real quick? Let's go back. Have some sandwiches on his grave.
Oh, dude. Hey, do you know where the bathroom's at?
Bathroom?
Yeah, where the bathroom's at?
Yeah, right here to the right.
All right, thanks. Hey, do you guys smoke weed? What? You guys smoke weed?
Every day.
Excuse me, campus police. I just talked to somebody and they said they smoke weed. Do you want to answer a quick question?
What's the question?
Dude, what's the question?
All right, yes.
Why don't you just ask the question instead of asking... Is this on video? Alright.
That's a good question. Actually, you asked me a question. That was good.
What was the question you were going to ask?
I was going to ask, do you have any meth and where can I get it?
I wish I had some meth right now because I'm about to die because of my my finals. Exams are killing me. I actually like challenging myself. I'm an engineering major, so I actually like challenging. I spend most of my time in the library. So hopefully we all make it through, you know? What's your name?
Jake.
Nice to meet you. Abdullah.
Your show now. Take it
over. Free t-shirts. You want a free t-shirt? So I want to know if you guys, if any of you guys smoke weed.
I'm just going to throw it wherever. I need more bits, dude. What's a good bit? I need more bits. I need good bits, good funny comedy bits to introduce these sketches. So many bits, these bits, man. These bits are driving me crazy. Good bits, funny bits, quick little short little bits. So many bits. Next sketch, play it.
So you know, it's one of those subliminal things.
Subliminal,
right?
Like when you're hanging out with a group of friends and you're all laughing and you look at someone you trust, you know?
Jessica, you're such a nerd.
That's why I'm here.
So this one time, I'm up at Max and Irma's, or like Bob Evans or whatever. And I'm next up to pay. It was like a long line. It was in College Town or something. And this old lady comes up to me. She hands me her bill and credit card. She's like, will you pay for me? And I'm like, no. Why would I do that? No. And she's like, wow. Do you have a sense of humor? I'm just joking.
Sick. Sick joke. Hilarious. Good prank, lady. Like, oh, can you carry my groceries for me? No? Wow, really? Do you have a sense of humor at all? I was just joking. Can you raise my kids for me? No, I'm not going to raise your kids for you, dude. Wow, really? I was just pranking you, dude. It was a sick prank. Whatever. You know, speaking of good pranks, this next sketch is about pranks. Isn't that funny how I did that? I told a story about not really even a prank, but I somehow, I didn't really relate it that well either, but I'm relating it now. Play the prank sketch. Just play the prank sketch.
I mean, at this point, I've seen it all. Hell, I've done it all. Yeah, I'm not innocent. I'm certainly not innocent.
I'm laughing at you now. You told me I was ugly. I was scared to crack a smile.
Ha! 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 Ha!
I'm laughing.
Hi. I'm sitting here?
Yeah.
Switch me. That's...
Alright then.
Yeah.
Let me put that on.
I just gotta check the loose screws. Hit it with the cushions. I always try to prank the prank master. This.
Alright, well, thanks for coming. Why don't you tell the people who you are?
They know who I am.
Okay. For those of you who don't know who this is Harold Prankmaster.
Okay.
Okay, I'll have one double cheeseburger.
I'm sorry?
One chicken sandwich, one double cheeseburger, and a fry.
This is Taco Bell. We don't have any of those items.
Oh, shit. Wait, what? You don't carry them anymore?
We've never had a chicken sandwich. We've never had burgers. We've never had fries.
Oh. Oh, all right. What do you serve here?
As the name Taco Bell would suggest, we serve tacos.
Oh. Do you have any burritos?
Why don't you take us back to where it all started?
Well, in the beginning, started small, you know. It wasn't really even about the views. It was just fun. Me and my friends, we'd go do voices at drive-thrus, you know, mess around on Xbox Live and stuff.
What kind of things did you do?
Well, on Xbox Live, we just, like, mess with people. You know, like I said, I had sex with, like, everyone's mother on there. But, reality, I never even, like, seen a breast. It's actually where I first learned about discrimination and racism, too.
How so?
Well, we do like the voices and skits, and I would do like, I do like the voice of a black dude, and I get called the N-word. Voice of a gay dude, and called the F-word. Voice of a Asian dude, called the C-word. You know, voice of a Southern dude, and get called a sister fucker. You know, we used to have this little group, but you know, people move on, they grow up, move away, die. So.
Excuse me, die?
Well, you must know, right?
I'm afraid I don't.
I mean, one of them died, but that was the prank, so.
Wait, what? What was the prank?
Okay. It was the death at a funeral prank. So, it was the prank, was for him to die at a funeral. But, you know, looking back at it, we probably shouldn't have done that one, though.
Because someone died?
Well, that, yeah, but, you want to watch the video on Live Leak, so we couldn't even monetize on it.
We out here. Walrus Gang going trick or treating day before Halloween.
Trick or treat.
It's a little early, isn't it?
Oh, it's like 7. It looks
bad. It starts like 7.
Yeah, that comes at like 7.
Halloween's tomorrow. Today's Sunday the 30th. Halloween's the 31st.
Oh, they changed it?
So many social experiments. You know, I'm practically a social scientist at this point.
How have social experiments gone for you?
Well, I've gone everywhere. I've had social experiments gone wrong, gone right, gone wild. gone sexual, gone black and gone back, gone viral disease. That was a weird one. Like, I've straight up committed felonies, but as long as you say it's a prank, they'll usually let you go.
That's not how that works.
I mean, it works for me. Usually just say, it's a prank, and like, alright, you're good to go.
Okay.
One time the prank was to get arrested. And so that was successful, actually. So that was the one time where I did get away, but also a successful prank, so.
And you probably deserve to be arrested.
That's what the cops said, too.
Getting back to the car.
Why? Oh, what do we
My car's parked at 1 mile from
Get in the car. You're being disorderly. You're disturbing what? People's peace.
Gone to the sixth dimension. Gone.
What was the sixth dimension? Was it good?
Oh, it was pretty cool. It was pretty chill.
Explain to me how you got there in vivid details.
Oh, you know, it was pretty chill. Hit up the sorcerer off Craigslist. Pretty cool dude. Name was Bill.
Was that under the personals or was that under the public?
Oh, public. Oh. So, yeah, pretty cheap. He was charging like $50 send you the sixth dimension, so. It was cool.
Was it drugs?
Surprise there.
It was drugs, wasn't it?
I think it was.
Be like, honest with me.
LSD mixed with heroin.
Yep.
After that, you know, gone to rehab and that done, so. Two-part. Go, camera's rolling.
Yeah, camera's rolling.
All right, 1 second. What about prank?
All right, I'd like, two Christmas burgers.
I'm sorry, what was
three that? the new Wendy's chicken taco.
I'm sorry, we
four beef stew sandwiches.
How did it even get this far?
Well, you know, the game changed. It was, people didn't want to see fun, innocent pranks anymore. But they were saying my pranks were too safe. But they weren't the ones doing it, you know? It takes courage to fart in an elevator full of people. It takes courage to order a cheeseburger at Taco Bell. And, you know, I got angry at them. I got angry at the fans. But I think mostly I was angry at myself. Because I knew if I didn't adapt the new wave of social experiments and these challenges and stuff that I would just fizzle out and I would no longer get the views, so.
Did you ever consider quitting?
No. Pranking isn't my DNA. I don't have a choice.
Yo, this is Harold from Wall's Gang and I take cars whenever there's one I want. I just, you know, snatch it up. You gotta go somewhere, gotta go.
Double cheeseburger, no cheese, no meat, just one bun.
No can do too. I like his voice. It's nice and deep and strong.
Yeah, but he's very strong.
Well, Harold, thank you.
Can you hold on 1 second? I have something I want to show everybody.
Yeah, sure.
Can we roll the tape real quick?
Alright guys, Hail Prankmaster here, gonna bring you something a little different today. Today's prank is the interview prank. Take it away, future me.
Wow. Okay, you got me there.
I can never stop.
Yeah, I can tell. Well, thanks for coming. It's great having you here.
Sure it was.
Really? Really? No, fuck this. This job. Fucking can't stand people.
So I got this infected hair follicle in my nose right now. It's all swollen. But you know, I decided to film anyways. Because you know what? We keep it real here at Cluster What? Alright? We keep it real. Play the next sketch. Get out of my face. I swear to God. I'm done with this. I'm sick of this. Death, a strange and terrifying thing that will eventually claim us all. It's something most people don't even think about or expect when it will come for them. Meet Chandra. Not only has she been thinking about her death, but she truly believes that today is the day she's going to die.
I truly believe that today's the day I'm gonna die.
Premonitions. Many have claimed to be able to see into the future, but very few have been able to actually predict upcoming events. Today we profile a renowned premonitionist, whose predictions not only came true, but were hauntingly accurate. Meet Chandra, who, just moments ago, not only predicted her own death, but was killed right here in this very spot, where she still lies in a pool of her own blood.
Alright, what is up, my Jakermeisters? It is Jake here again with another weekly vlog. So, I know you've all been wondering, the mail lady incident has blown over. Finally got that resolved. Feeling in my pinky toe is also back, which I'm really happy about. It's also a beautiful day here today. I'm on campus right now, just got out of class. Thought I'd give you guys another vlog. So, well, I'll see what, tell you what's going on in my life. While I'm, hey, what's up?
Camera down there.
Oh, sorry, dude. I'm just filming a little.
Bro, I don't like being filmed.
Oh, what? Wait, what's up?
Do you mind?
I'm just filming a little something, bro. You can.
Are you sure? Get the camera out of my face.
I'm just filming a little.
Put the camera down.
All right, yeah, just down, dude. All right, so that was. Oh, what's up?
Dude. Do you mind? I'm trying to get to my class right now, bro.
All right, man. That's all good. All right, see y'all. I'm going this way.
Put the camera down, man.
All right, I'm just going this way, dude. So, all right, so what?
Dude, I'm trying to get to my class.
Oh my god, what the hell is this?
I'm trying to get to my dude.
Oh, I'm sorry, dude. Oh, I'm sorry. All right, so, dude, what's up?
Last time, just put the camera down, dude. I don't like to be filmed, man. Seriously, stop.
Dude, you're walking into my camera, bro.
No, I'm, dude. My class is right there.
All right, dude.
Just put the camera down.
Your class is right there.
Right there, dude.
All right, dude. You're walking into my shot.
Are you sure?
All right, guys. I'm back. Sorry about all that. Back in the office now, I had to get away from that crazy guy. He was really annoying. I don't know why he kept walking right into the camera.
Dude, stop filming me.
What the hell
did you get
in here?
I don't think you're permission to film me, bro. I've asked you a couple times, stop.
You broke in my office to tell
me
that?
I'm not even kidding. Stop, dude. Dude, just get that.
Okay, everyone. I am back. Sorry about all this. I just was not feeling safe around that man. So I decided to just go home instead and before I finish this, because that was just, he was really creeping me out. I truly believe that guy was insane, so. If you're wondering, am I driving right now and filming? Well, yes I am, but I'm a professional, so don't try this at home. Yeah, so back to the whole wooden spoon ordeal. It was a weird night. It was a very, oh my god. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding?
What the? From school, then my office, now in my neighborhood, really? Stop
filming,
bro. I'm not even.
Oh my god. Oh my god.
Dude.
All right, on my way to the pool. It's like 9 o'clock here in California. Absolutely beautiful day here. See the palm trees right here. Oh my god, it is beautiful here. Loving this weather. Gorgeous place. Time for a quick swim, gotta relax. Catch some rays, you know what they say. And what the fuck? What the fuck? What the fuck? What are you? Alright everyone, I'm in Canada now. Fled the border to get away. Beautiful day though today at the GM building. Detroit cityscape. Nice day, nice breeze.
Again, bro.
Oh
again.
My god, are you kidding me?
What's up? Thanks for watching Cluster What? Yep. If you watch the whole thing, send me a message or comment saying, yo, I watched it all, dude. All right. That's it, dude. Yup. Just chilling here. Dude, I don't even know what's going on anymore, dude. Shouts out to the people that helped out, dude. Shouts out to Student Media Productions. Shouts out to me, because it's my show. Shouts out Shia LaBeouf. Shouts out to the Pope. Shouts out to Crocodile Dundee.
Cluster what?